Hi, my name is Caroline Schofield and I'm a visual artist. I am going to be doing a project with you around monoprinting and the garden. And what I'm looking for is that you will go out and collect leaves and things in your garden. So we have leaves here, I have leaves in my hands that I've already collected. And what would be great is wherever you are today that you go outside and see what leaves have you got in the garden. If you don't have them in your garden, you could go for a walk around the area and pick up leaves on the way and talk about those leaves and what do they feel like and what can you see in those leaves. Or you could invite people who are coming in to work with you to bring leaves from their gardens. So these are some leaves that I have picked today, and what I am looking for when I look at these leaves is these types of ridges. So you can see this really beautiful leaf, but this is the side here that we'll be printing, and you can see you're getting all of this and you're going to get a really beautiful print from that. And the other thing that I love printing is fennel, and the reason why is you get really beautiful marks, but you also get these really beautiful smells from the fennel. So it's like it's crushed, and that's a really nice thing when you're working with people, when you start getting these smells up. So you could be trying to print lots of different herbs. To do monoprinting, you need very few things. So we started with collecting our leaves from the garden. And then for monoprinting, you need a roller, which is very inexpensive. And the great thing about rollers is you have that whole tactile experience. So even if somebody can't print, but they will enjoy touching and feeling this equipment. And particularly for men, they really enjoy the fact of the equipment and how it goes together. So that's a roller. And I am using just one color today, which is white. And this is a lino block printing ink. The inks are, again, relatively inexpensive, and they are they wash out really, really easily. If you don't have either of these pieces of equipment, you could use one of your paintbrushes, and you can use your acrylic paints that you already have. And instead of using the roller, you're going to paint the acrylic onto the leaves. Now, you won't get as sharp as a result, but you will get beautiful results. The other thing that I use is laminated sheets of paper or card that are laminated. So this one's A3, but you could use an A4 as well, particularly if you're tight for space. So today I'm using black sugar paper, which is, again, relatively inexpensive. And I'm also, the other thing that you can use is, if you don't have that, is you can use photocopier paper, which you probably have in work already. So to start monoprinting, we're going to take some of our block printing ink and we're going to put it on the laminated sheet. We're then going to get our roller and we're going to roll some ink onto that roller. Okay, and then I am going to get this leaf that I chose earlier, and I'm going to use the back of this leaf because of all these veins. I'm just going to very simply, and I am following the line of the leaf to get this print. So when people are putting the ink on, it's just the feel of the roller. Don't worry about how much ink goes on or whether they've got everything. So we're not looking for perfection here. Okay. Now I'm going to get two pieces of sugar paper. So I'm going to put one piece down. I'm going to get the leaf and I'm going to lay it on that piece of paper. So I'm just using A4 paper here at the moment. And then I'm going to lie the second piece on top of it. And then I am just going to rub it. So the best way of rubbing it is if you hold the spine in where it is and you can feel the whole way along that spine. And you just go around and you rub it like this. So this is lovely to work with people where they get to feel the leaf. They feel it and they can work with you on it. You don't need to be precious about this. You'll get some really beautiful prints, but it may take a few goes. Okay, and then when you finish that, you peel the top piece off. And look at that print. Isn't that just stunning? So we've got all those beautiful, beautiful lines. So what I would be doing with that is, that can sit as itself one piece. You could laminate that and put that up on the walls. Or you could do a whole group piece where you get a larger piece of paper and you start printing these and printing up people's gardens. It would also be lovely to have words on this, of what the plant is, what its name is, whose garden did it come out of. That would be really beautiful. So that's the first print. I'm going to take a second print of that now just to see what we get the second time. And that's just the underpeck piece. Just get some more ink. I'm going to put the leaf on top of that. And again, we're just going to rub it. And peel off the top piece. And see, we're getting some ink on the bottom piece there. And then peel off this. And again, look at how beautiful that is. What I also like about that is when you start putting them together as pieces. So this could be a whole wall of prints. You could use these prints for cards as artistic pieces. You can even print onto fabric and let your just pin your fabric on the wall and see what happens with that.